if we get to know the probability of us falling a prey to a particular disorder in advance? What if we can predict serious disorders like cancer using simple medical testing? Is that possible? Or is it just fiction? Well, no. It's already being done. The concept of genetic testing, or the technique in which our genes or chromosomes are tested, help us here. So what are chromosomes? We've always come across the saying, humans have 23 pairs of chromosomes. But what are they made up of? And where are they actually located in the cell? Let's try and answer all of these queries in this session. Here we have this simple cell as an example. Can you see the thread-like structures here in the nucleus? These threads are called chromatids. They are usually tangled in this fashion when present in a regular active cell. Now, what if the cell has to undergo division? Is it possible to divide this single cell into two equal halves with such a tangled bundle of threads? Of course not. Imagine we have these different colored threads tangled together. If we were to separate them, then what should be the first thing we should do? We will first separate each thread and then make separate bunches. In a similar way, even the cells separate these chromatid threads. This process is aided by condensation of the threads. It means these chromatid material will gradually start coiling like a telephone wire. As a result, the threads will gain structures like these. Are we familiar with this kind of a structure? Have we come across it before? That's correct. It is the structure of a typical chromosome. What are chromosomes? Well, we'll get into their details in the upcoming sessions. For now, we need to get a basic idea about them. So we have this cell with threads sorted in this classical chromosome structure. This structure is seen only when the cell is in the process of division. So can we say that both chromatids and chromosomes are the same? Yes, they are. The different names are for the different structures. Now the next question is, what are these threads, or chromosomes to be precise, made up of? If we zoom into the structure of this chromosome, we find small segments like these that make up the complete structure. These functional segments are nothing but genes. So can we say that chromosomes are made up of genes? Absolutely. All these segments make up the whole structure. Now let me ask you one more interesting question. Do you think the genes will also be made up of something? Will there be units that make up these segments? If your answer is yes, then you're absolutely right. Genes are also made up of some units. If we zoom inside this gene segment, then we find large molecules like these that make up the segment. These large molecules, or macromolecules to be precise, are DNA molecules. This is not a new term for us. We are quite familiar with the term DNA as it's very commonly used these days. But what exactly are these DNA molecules? Well, this single large molecule is composed of three units. And what units are these? Let's reserve this explanation for our upcoming videos. For now, all we need to know is that DNA is made up of these units. Now, to quickly review what we learnt, let me remove the text from the screen. These three combine to give us a single molecule. And many such DNA molecules form long chains. What is a sequence of DNA molecules called? That's right, it's called a gene. So technically, segments of DNA molecules which form functional units are called genes. And many genes come together to form thread-like structures called chromosomes. Chromosome is the classical structure obtained only during cell division. When the cell is not in the dividing phase, the genetic material is present in the form of tangled threads called chromatids. So this is the basic idea of the genetic materials in our cells, which we needed to understand in order to look at the laws in genetics. Let's get introduced to the laws in genetics put forth by Gregor Mendel in the next part.